what do you think? How much cost a tube microphone with variable polar pattern?
I think more than 200, 300 euro.
Okay.
At least.
Okay.
Guys, if you believe or not, I find a tube microphone with variable polar pattern and with the transformer big like this in a Justin Music shop in the last time when I went for the Yamaha Ag06 mixer, and they have over there a pile of products what they even are not listing, eh? They are not listing on their website. So you just can pick up these things over there and you just can be shocked over there about the prices. I have now with me a bit of money, not so much, just a bit of money. Let's see what we can pick up from the Justin Music. Okay guys, if somebody ever see some really weird expensive microphone to cut a tube in half, this is a Neumann 87 microphone and it's cut to the half to show you what is inside. Unbelievable. We will take some kind of picture because I never can achieve this microphone to do a teardown, huh? Really nice. So yeah. So this is the entries of the Just Music. We went into the shop and I was completely wrong. So we couldn't find a microphone for 100 euro, which is a tube microphone. And it has a variable pattern of the sound. You know, guys, the high-end, high-level of tube microphones, you can choose between different patterns like cardioid or 8 pattern 8 or circular pattern. And actually the microphone is there, just the price is not good. So somebody, when I was there in the last time to pick up this Yamaha Ag06 joke mixer, somebody placed other tube microphone price to it. And so the difference is only 100 euro exactly. But we stayed there for a couple of minutes and then we, okay, for 199, this is maybe too much. So we picked the other microphone for 99 euro, which is still a good deal, I think. It's a really good deal because we find this microphone on the Amazon for 198 euro or something like this. New, the second hands are running on 128. Nothing fancy. It's this big Behringer T1 microphone. I don't have any microphone from the Behringer, and this is the first time when I bought it some microphone from the Behringer. Anyway, the purpose of this microphone, I hunted for some kind of microphone here to the lab, because here in a lab, you know, guys, there is dust, there is a fume from the soldering station. So this is not the cleanest place in the world for install a stationary microphone. And here, really, I don't wanna kill my AKG perception microphone. I look for some microphone what I will install here, and it will be always be here. We place some plastic bag on top of it. As I read on the internet, it's not a bad microphone. Of course, for 99 euro, it's absolutely a lovely microphone, yeah? It's like a good deal, I think. Come on, guys, it's a tube microphone. So let's see what is inside. By the way, guys, over there in this shop, if you believe or not, every section, it's a huge shop. It's like five floors. Each floor has its own professionality, and the building itself is huge. There is an elevator inside, and really big, like every floor, I think it's like
like 2,000 square meter or 1,000 square meter, something like this. Every section in this shop have a small area where they collecting beware open-end boxes or things which is under sales. But what is really interesting, those things are not listed on their website at all. So if you wanna pick up cheap but good stuffs, you must go to there. And you just be shocked. We find other unit, this really nice stereo high-end amplifier. It's a really small, I don't wanna say no the type and the name because somebody will jump there and will pick up. And we find a lot of other stuffs which is really like, it's we just, I don't know, we will maybe take it or not take it. So yeah, we hesitated a bit. Guys, you hear it? No, like this. No, like this.
Stop.
Don't be ugly with this company. I think the Behringer is doing a nice business because the Behringer is trying to produce relatively good gears for cheap money. And the small home studios like me here in a BMS studio, we're always looking for some good deals and shalala. And I think there is not so huge problems with the Behringer. Look this. I thought this was much more smaller.
Really big.
It's really big. Come on. Oh, guys, it's like 1.5 kilogram of pure metal. Look at this. And look this size. Yeah, so it's almost in every aspect, it's like 1.5 times bigger, yeah? Even windshield. Now it's much more bigger. Look at this, €199, unbelievable. Yeah, I was really happy with this deal, no. Because I thought it's really like smaller, but this is really a beast of machine. I think this will be our next reporter microphone, no? Like, Guten Tag! Yeah? Yeah, Guten Tag, yeah. I think it looks decent, no?
Yeah.
It's like €99, come on. The holder, yeah, this is when the things is get, yeah, it's cheap, it's plastic. Yeah, the screw is metal, but anything else, everything is just plastic. I'm telling you guys, this one is really tough. It's tough. Now let's put it in now. Like, I hope it will work. So, yeah, it can hold, absolutely. And it has, some kind of damping. I can't read. Okay, I try. Yeah, Yongsheng. Okay, so Yongsheng the connector, and there is nothing. No, nothing text on the cable at all. Zero. And oh, very nice touch, guys. Ground lifting. Thank you very much, Behringer. And the case, I think it's okay, no? Yeah, these kind of cases are running on €20 or 10 or 15, 30 euros, something like this. Take to the parts or power up? I want to see this red, huh?
Yeah,
okay, so let's power up. I cannot, like, come on. It's okay for €99. Don't forget, €99. Some kind of diamond, yeah? So they give you also that blue diamond. So here it is. The tube is light up, but I think it's just mimic. No, it's not mimic.
And now we will do immediately a teardown. Yeah? All this is metal, yeah? Then you have a grounding cable, a proper one. So this is not a joke cable. This is actually a size of a normal AC line grounding cable, which is going there, where is the copper mounting for your mic stand. So yeah, this is a really nice touch. I really like it, and they did it properly. You know, guys, there is a hole on the middle, and then a screw is going on, and you see the screw is locked with some kind of red glue. Yeah, we have to manage all this mic from the. Everything here, this is metal. There is a proper foam. Even there is another second layer of metal grid. So it's really like produced really beautifully, absolutely beautiful. And the whole case and everything is really nice. And then we have here this. What is this? I don't know what this is. But at least we can replace it, no? With something else, yeah. Okay, this we will replace it to something else, yeah? I think I will take the Russian capsule, which is, sounds really good. Octava, yeah. Octava have a really nice capsule for nothing, for like $30 or something like this, with gold plating and all this shalala. So I will take an Octave capsule here and I will install to here, because this is really a joke. By the way, we didn't hear the sound. Maybe it sounds good, no? Yeah. But come on, for 99 euro, it's okay. This is also nice, so there is a holding to the tube. So yeah, when you, unfortunately, if you fall down your mic, then the tube will not broke on the neck, because there is some kind of, I think this is silicone. So it's temperature treated, some kind of rubber. This transformer is from Billion Professional Series 12AX7 from BBB.
Bugera,
yeah.
It's their own tube.
So this is Behringer? Mm-hmm. Behringer tube. Rest of the electronics, I don't know. It has to be, it can be better design. Because I see here transistors, yeah? I see here, I think it's a bit too much for a tube amplifier. And don't forget also we have here this electronic. By the way, I don't know why, really guys, I really no have clue. In every tube amplifier what I opened in my life, the tube is here. Like, this part is the farthest from the mic preamp. From the mic, sorry, from the capsule. Here is like, and then this transformer is not closed, so this is open coil transformer. I'm telling you guys, the worth of the money is only the case. I really like this case. It's machined, absolutely beautiful. Only this window, which is showing you the tube under operation, it's kind of, maybe they did this to here to make sure they can show the light. There is nothing acoustic, because the heat, the problem with this arrangement, the heat is like going upward immediately to the capsule. So when you rotate your tube, then your tube is at the bottom is heat, and of course, because of that, all the good heat, because this heat is kind of good heat, is just passing the tube. So it's warming up much more faster inside the filaments. Here, this is not the case. Maybe they don't want to warm up the tube fastly, or I really don't know, have clue. This is capacitive, you think? Yeah, there is adjustment. Really interesting. This small membrane, maybe you can see here. You can zoom on it? Yeah. There is a adjustment on a membrane. But still, this is a small diaphragm membrane. Yeah, this is not a proper 1 inch or 1.5 inch. Will be replaced to octava. Don't worry. It looks like an XLR. And I was here, I was right. You know what's the brand? Chunsheng. So it's a Chunsheng 7-pin Chinesium XLR. No, this is not XLR. Connector Changchung. Ching Changchung. I think there is a reason why they use the plastic. But maybe if we replace it to wood. Huh? I have a wood workshop. Come on. So I can do this inside from wood, like rosewood even. Then I think I will also take off the paint from this hose, and I will polish up this one, this part here. And we will write on it BMR Terminator 1, T1. So this I will polish down all, these two. Okay, the grill I will just clean it from the paint, because it's also painted on the same color like the whole grill. Then I will have, I think this I will take out. This shalala, I don't need this. So this I will cover with some really nice copper. And here we where we replace the logo. And of course I will replace the capsule to octava capsule. Don't forget, still 99 euro, and still the purpose for that is to permanently install here to my lab. Oh, there is other transformer, which is closed. A lot of goodies here, even more than what I thought, eh? Yeah, it's packed. It's really ugly. So here is the diamond, here is the power transformer, a proper power switch. Yeah, this at least this I like it. And then, proper isolated input, fuse. Until that, everything is fine. They're not playing with shit. They did isolation from the high voltage, a real one, so they cut the PCB to make sure there is nothing can leak to your microphone from the main line. So you see that capacitor? I think this is this must be non-microphonic capacitor. But this transformer, yeah, I think it's based on a Haufe design, and the other part it's like I just guessing, yeah. So it can be something else, but first look, it's like absolutely the shape and the height. And the touch and the feel is this half transformers. Every part's even through hole. Yeah, they not did here some kind of really sophisticated ground lifting technology, push-pull transistors or whatever. They just when you press it, then it's cut the ground. But at least you have ground lifting. You know what is this brand RB? I never see. Again, this Decon. Thank you very much, Decon. And guys, even in one in one product, in one case, yeah, from the four capacitor, there is three brand. Sorry, not band. Yeah, it can be fat, both of them. I think they are running in push-pull configuration, simple B class, like a preamp for your mic, because this is actually sitting behind of your microphone and is driving the transformer. So this is kind of a nice design. I don't know, it's running somewhere here. So I don't know, guys. We have to do some kind of more reverse engineering, or maybe there is some semantic already on the internet about this. But yeah, for 99 euro, okay, okay. Yeah, look this transformer fixing. It's amazing. I think the Chinese guy or woman, I think she, let's call she. So she is running out from the screws. Look, or I don't know, really, really, guys, I'm really confused. But this side of the transformer is fixed with a proper screw. So everything is screwed together, yeah? But on this side, it's not the case. It's even planned like this. So there is a cut. You see that? There is a cut. I don't know why. If somebody knows the answer why they one side is metal screw and the other is just this zip, like, and actually this is the proper isolation what I spoke about. So the ground, you see, it's on a proper really fat PCB line is going to the ground, to the whole chassis, exactly in the middle. So it's like the ground is spreading, let's say, almost equally in every corner. Then here you see this two cut, which is isolating the PCB from the, is the part, this part is the low voltage part and this part is the high voltage part. But I don't see here isolation. Maybe this distance is like almost 1.5 centimeter. This is enough to isolate the part of the, this is the tube input. But this one here, it's really, really isolated. So the high voltage part is isolated from the transformer secondary part, which is here. And as you see, every diode, I think this is also a nice touch. So every diode has its own, when the voltage is going down and the diode is start to close, there is a very small time when the diode can oscillate. So not every great, not every diode bridge is working perfectly because of that. So they installed here 4 pieces of capacitor and each diode get one. And then there is another line. I think this is what is powering the filament voltage. This is also contained, but smaller capacitors and lower quality. This is normal ceramic cups, but these ones are not. Yeah, you know what, let me clean, yeah? Because it looks already like oxidated or damaged. Yeah, new gear. At least this came off. Yeah. Go again here. Okay, I think it's enough. Now nice, it's fully cleaned. €100. Now, guys, I will switch off on the camera the low cut filter, okay, and then I lower the sensitivity. Low cut is off, and now we rise up the sensitivity of this. Okay, tell me if the signal is good. It actually sounds better than I thought. Like, really, guys, even this microphone is plastic inside this capsule, hopefully. So let's turn it. No, this is the back, I think, yeah. This is the back. This is much more moody. Yeah, this is really nice. Look, now I'm speaking about 50 centimeter from the microphone and I'm continuously changing the position of my head
And I think it's a kind of constant. It's not bad. So let's go closer. Of course, then we get a proximity effect from the microphone. And what's happening if I'm speaking to the top? Well, it's really like really moody. But I'm telling you guys, from this distance, I even can sing to it. No, I will not sing. Don't worry, I will not destroy your ears, guys. Low cut filter, which is in the Behringer. So I hope we will not make some bump. If it's, yeah, it's actually designed nicely. So it's not made this bump. So again, this is without low cut filter, I think. And this is with. Now the low cut filter is on. Let's check this minus 20 dB. This is made some kind of bump. Yeah, this is really bad. So let's check now this ground lifting, because now the camera is, of course, is powered on battery. And this unit is connected to the AC. So I hope nothing will happen. But now you can hear, this is the situation when you must need to apply the grounding from one point. So the ground lifting is working. I'm speaking into the mic like 50 centimeter, and yeah, it's picking up. And I think, don't forget, now we on a gain. How much gain we have now? Now we like 4 from the 10. So we really don't have to drive the mic preamp in my camera. So it's meaning it will be much more better even on my new professional Yamaha Ag06 mixer, which is always frozen on me. Guys, this will be my broadcasting microphone. I hope you guys will like it, the sound of this. And of course, later on, as I told you guys, I will modify everything here. Let me do the reporter mic style. Oh. Yeah, bitte. This is my voice with Behringer T1 tube plastic metal condenser microphone at cross windshield. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. See you next time. Bye.